A very warm good morning to one and all present over here class. Welcome to the digital platform of APS. Now this is Pawan Kumar. Today I will start 8th lecture of chapter 11, three-dimensional geometry. So class, in previous lecture I have discussed vector equation of a line passing through 1 point and passing through 2 points. Now I have completed angle between two lines or vector equations whose vector equations are given. Now in today lecture I will discuss skew lines or shortest distance between two lines. So what is skew lines? Come to the new heading, skew lines. New heading is skew lines. What is skew lines? Suppose you have given two straight lines which are neither parallel nor intersecting. So this line is said to be skew lines. Suppose this is line L1. This is line L1 representing three-dimensional space. This is x-axis, this is z-axis, and this is y-axis. Now this is a line L1, and now any other line is L2 representing three-dimensional space. Now you will see when the line L1 is not parallel to L2, means L1 is not parallel to L2, and they will not intersect to each other. So suppose this is the line L1, L1 and L2. So how will you define skew lines? Two lines which are neither parallel nor intersecting. Neither parallel nor intersecting. Are known as skew lines. From figure, line L1, line L1 and L2 are neither parallel nor intersecting. Neither parallel nor intersecting. So this line is known as skew lines. L1 and L2 are skew lines from this figure. So one important point is here, skew lines are not coplanar. It is clear that two skew lines are never coplanar. Never coplanar. Two skew lines are never coplanar. Now I will come to the next heading. The next heading is line of shortest distance, means shortest distance between two lines or two skew lines. How will you calculate shortest distance between two skew lines? See, Now, next heading is line of shortest distance. Line of shortest distance. So, let us consider, let L1 and L2 are any two skew lines representing three D space as shown in figure. L1 L2 are two lines that represent in three dimensional space. Then this is skew lines. Then there is one and only one line. There is one and only one line, you can say, perpendicular to each of line L1 and L2. Means suppose you have two skew lines, then there will be one and only one line which is perpendicular to the each of line L1 and L2. Suppose this is the point, suppose P, and this is the point, suppose Q. Is known as line of shortest distance. Line of shortest distance. Now, in note point, in figure, PQ line is line of shortest distance. PQ line is line of shortest distance. See, again see, L1, L2 are two skew lines representing three dimensional space. Then there is one and only one line perpendicular to each of line L1 and L2. This is known as shortest distance or line of shortest distance. And in figure, it is clear that PQ line is the line of shortest distance. Now this topic is completed. Now come to the next heading. The next heading is shortest distance. Now, new heading is shortest distance. Shortest distance. What is shortest distance? From figure, shortest distance is the line of shortest distance. Shortest distance between two skew lines is the line of shortest distance. This is the line of shortest distance, PQ. Means when you will measure PQ, then it will be the shortest distance. Means let L1 and L2 be any two skew lines represent in 3D space and a PQ is the line of shortest distance. PQ is the line of shortest distance. Then the line of shortest distance is known as shortest distance between two SQ lines. Means from figure it is clear line PQ is the shortest distance. Shortest distance is equal to, you can write, distance between PQ. This is the shortest distance between two lines. See. There are two important points we have to remember related to shortest distance between two lines. So, see, now note point first point is here. If two lines intersect each other, then the shortest distance between lines R 0. Two lines intersect each other in case the shortest distance between them or between two lines is 0. Second point, if two lines are parallel, if two lines are parallel, then the shortest distance between them distance between them is the distance between two parallel lines. Is the distance between parallel lines. This is the important points we should have to remember. See, now I will come to the next heading, shortest distance between two SQ lines in vector form. See, now new heading is shortest distance between two lines, and this is in vector form. Let L1 and L2 be any two lines represent in 3D space such that or whose vector equations are suppose we are taking R vector is equal to vector A plus lambda B1 and vector R is equal to suppose this is A1 and this is A2, A2 vector plus lambda B2 vector. See, suppose we are changing its scalar quantities, so mu, suppose we have taken two neither intersecting non-parallel lines, so these point are these lines are not intersecting, so A1 A2 will be different and non-parallel means B1 will not equal to B2. Then suppose this is L1 and this is L2. I am writing here as it is, L1 such that vector R is equal to vector A1 plus lambda B1 vector, and L2 line vector R is equal to A2 vector plus mu B2 vector. Now, the shortest distance between two lines, the shortest distance between two lines L1 and L2 is denoted by suppose D, is denoted by D and defined by what is the value of D? D is equal to see A2 minus A1. We have to subtract first A2 minus A1. So vector A2 minus vector A1 into, we have to take their cross product of non-parallel lines. So B1 cross B2 whole upon this is mod of B1 cross B2 and distance is always positive, so you will take their mod. So this is the formula to calculate the distance between two skew lines, which is shortest distance between two skew lines. Now this is the complete formula. See, now I will come to the points or shortest distance between two lines that will be in Cartesian form. Cartesian form line equation is given. So what will be the shortest distance between two lines in Cartesian form? See, Cartesian form. So let us consider two lines L1 and L2 represented in Cartesian plane. Two lines L1 and L2 represent in Cartesian plane. Suppose three dimensional space whose Cartesian equations are L1 such that, suppose L1 is x minus x1 upon a1, x minus x1 upon a1 is equal to y minus y1 upon b1 is equal to z minus z1 upon c1. This is the Cartesian equation of line. Now L2 will be x minus x2 upon a2 is equal to y minus y2 upon b2 is equal to z minus z2 upon c2. This is the Cartesian equation of a line whose direction cosines, direction ratios and passing points are given. Now we have to calculate it's the shortest distance between two lines. So shortest distance between two lines L1 and L2 such that L1 and L2 is denoted by D and defined by C. This formula is D is equal to in determinant you have to solve value, means x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, and next z2 minus z1, and A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. This is the value or determinants term. And whole upon its value is what will be its value in a fractions or a denominator, is sigma means summation a1 b2 minus a2 b1 whole square. Suppose a1 b2 minus b2 a1 whole square. So this is D. This is value D. And you can expand a1 b2 minus a2 b1, b1 c2 minus b2 c1, and plus c1 b2 c1 a2 minus c2 b1 a1. This is the expression. Now this topic is totally completed. See.